Hi, my name is Enoch, and welcome to Indies Tech. In this video, it's been a while we had a video on Python, but we're going to be talking about Python programming, and we're still in the building blocks of the things that would need in making programs and codes for the things that we want to do. So what are we learning today? Today we're going to be talking about lists and list operations. Part of the things that we do when we are trying to make automations for things to do repetitive tasks is that that's part of the things that Python does. And in order to do that, we will have to learn how to use some of these basic building blocks in having mastery and running these operations. So what is list? List is a value or a variable that contains multiple values in an ordered sequence, and they are written with square brackets. Of course, we're going to write some code so you would get to see how you write list and make use of it when writing codes. So, but basically, this is what list is. In automations, we get to have how to use some of this list, and you get to see it as we progress, right? So I just opened my IDLE, and on the shell editor, I would like to just create a particular list, say my family, and I'll just write it as fun. See, and of course, for a list can hold different data types. Meanwhile, a list is also a data type in Python. So let's say we have Jim as part of the family member. We have Kim. We have Kim as part of our family member. We have our dog whose name is 30.5. That's the name of the dog. And we also have a true. We have a cat that we call him True. And we also have my dad, his name is Father, say for instance, or this is called Michael. And of course, because it's a string data type, I'll have to put it in quotation. Now, I basically used the, and we also have another dog whose name is Ted, is 68. That's the name of the dog. His name is 68. So I basically created this data type having this list having different or different types of data types to show that in a list you can have multiple data types, and it yet doesn't break that rank that it's a list. And you can see for all the string data type they have to be in a quotation. For the boolean data type, because it's written integer data type, and the floating data type. So it's basically how it works. So in for instance, and to say that, just like you know, if I were to ask what is the length of the item in this list, so I use the length function and I say the length of fun, it will give me six. And in this family that I defined, we have six items, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So we have six items in the family list. Now, of course, these items are indexed, and the range goes from 0 to the end. So you have 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So if I were to call a particular item, if I were to want to extract any item from this list, maybe in my code, so I want to see, can I get a particular value from this item, and I know the index number. So I want to get the name of my dog, and I know my dog is 30.5. That's his name. So what I'll just have to do is to do fun. Can you give me the item on 3, on 2? And it brings it 30.5, 30.5012. That's the third. That's the third item, technically. That's the third item, ideally, but that's the second item, technically, because it runs from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So these are a few things you could do. And again, let's say I define another data type, another list to be names of, okay, let's just use Tor. Let's say I have a store, yeah. So I have a store, and in that store, I have a T. Of course, it's a string data type, so I have to put it on a quotation. I have T. I have bread. I have sugar. Also, I have coffee. Yep. Say, for instance, this is what I have in my store. Now, I have these two lists. I can combine this list. I can combine this list to form another list, right? And so, let's say I want to form another list that's family store. That's the name of the list. On from another list that is family store. And I want to say that, please could you add farm and store to form this list. So, alright, so yeah, this is an invalid syntax. Let me repeat this and have, okay, family store. Alright, let's do this way. Yeah, okay. So if I were to say, can you please give me this list name error, or this is not what I typed. So if I were to give, sorry, family store, am I making, or is store not your? So you would see that in this list, I now have the combination of all of these. So this time around, if I were to ask, can I get the length of family store? If I were to ask the length of family store, you see it's 10 items because I have 4 items on store and 7 items. So I can concatenate, I can put two lists together to form a list, and there are many things I could do with this. Part of this is that, let's say I do not have the index and I'm trying to find a particular item in the list. So for instance, I don't know the list. This could be very wide range. Now in reality, when you are making, when you're writing a code and you define a number of items in a list, and you may not know what particular index it is, there is a method that you could, that we call index. So I could use that function to find out I could use that index to find out what's the value, what's the index of that of a particular okay, so let's say true. Let me use true. It gets to see what I'm saying. Alright, let's say 30.5 attributes error. So the reason why you are seeing this error, because index is supposed to be in small letters. So if we're gonna do this, so you find this. So 3.0 is the second item. This is the second index. So I'm able to find out what particular index, maybe while I'm writing the code, I want to use this. I don't know the index, but I want to find out the index. I could use this function to really do that. Or maybe again, I'm writing a code and I want to know if I have, say for instance, we wrote a program for a storekeeper that wants to check, and a customer comes to the store seeking for a wheelbarrow. And then he cannot remember if he has a wheelbarrow. So he goes to the program, and then you're writing the code in the back end. You want to check if it's possible to know if I have a wheelbarrow as part of my items. So one of the things I can do is I could use this. So if a wheelbarrow in my store, if you have a wheelbarrow in family store, print, I could say that I should get an, yes, we have a wheelbarrow. Yeah, so yes, we have a wheelbarrow. Else, you will find out where there will be an error in this code because I'm writing a full code on the shell editor. This should have been done in a file editor, just so that we can continue to use it. But I'm going to transfer this to a file editor, so I will just have to write it and then copy it to a file editor. No, we don't. No, we don't have a wheelbarrow. So yeah, no, we don't have a wheelbarrow. So we don't have a wheelbarrow. So let's open a new file and then let's paste this family store. This is gonna be a lot. So let's do this. Let's take this. Let's put it into our file editor. Let's take these two lines of code so that we don't have to write them over again. Yeah, so we have this as family store. Then we can take this to and put it here. Alright. Yeah, so we can run this code and of course we have to save it. So let's save it as let's save it in the desktop as listing.py. Alright. Okay. Alright, yeah, this is wrong. We don't store space variable name. So let's do this here. So if we do that, let's see what runs here. So you see in this code you say no, we don't have a wheelbarrow because it was just directly to say to it was we don't have a wheelbarrow as part of family store. So the code, the output is no, we don't have a wheelbarrow. But practically speaking, we can also do a few things with this. So for instance, can I comment on this line so that it doesn't have to be executed? Yeah. Alright, so if I comment on the line, I don't have to execute it. There's a few things we can also do with this code. For instance, remember we're saying that the code begins to run. So for instance, let's just say family store. If I were to get this as family store, if I were to just print it, you'd see on the output, it would give me a list of what we have as family store. So when we do this, okay, what's going on? All right, so for instance, when I want to call this, I may just, for instance, I can call a particular range of the items within the, I can call a particular range of the item within the list using columns. They are called slices. So I can, and slices can go from negative to positive or whatever. So for instance, if I do from 0 to 3, If I save it from 0 to 3, I want to print family stuff from 0 to 3. So let me just use the print, the output statement print. Print family stuff from 0 to 3. And I run the code. Let's see how it goes on. So you see what goes on here? What happens here is it goes from Jim, Kim, and 3.0, 3.30.5. This is the first three. And I can keep reducing this list. I can say, okay, I may not have to put zero since I know I'm starting from the first. I could just use column to three. It will still run the same code. So let's do that and see. You still find out that it still did 0 to 3, so that in my slices, I may not have to write all of the codes. And also in the same manner, I can just remove this and just write a column, and it will still bring out all of the items within the list. It will still bring out all of the items within the list. There are a few things, and this is very important that we know some of these manipulations, because they come very handy in writing our code. For instance, the one advantage of writing codes in writing lists is to avoid what we call duplications of code in programming, such that, for instance, I want to define the names of the people in the family, like, you know, so I would like name one in order to avoid things like Kim. Alright, name three, so in order to keep, instead of having these duplications, I could just put this in a list just like I did, and just have to call them, and it will cause my code to not be as bulky, and it will make it a little bit easy, it will make it readable, and, you know, as we get better, we don't have to do all of this. So this is part of the reasons why you have cats. And of course, let's say, for instance, you want to write a code that makes the user to insert multiple names. You could do that. So okay, let's run that. So let's write this as the last code for this under lists. For instance, we are having batteries low. So for instance, we are going to be having a store. Let's say a store. Let's define it a store. Let's define it as an empty list. And let's call it store, and we want to write a code, so it goes while true print that enter the items in your store. Enter the items in your store, or enter in to exit. Right. So I have this code, and then I would write, let me call it item as whatever the user puts in item. As this, so I could write an if statement. I could say that if item is an empty string, I could say it should break out from the loop, and then I could, you know, insert the item that the person put into the lists. So I can have item. Then, you know, I could just this loop basically begins to insert these items that the the user puts into the list as store, and that would be that. So I could just decide to leave the loop indentation and print store. If that happens, okay, I could just print store and let's run this. I still saved it as alright, let's cancel this. Yes, let's kill it and run it afresh so that's it. So yeah. So in this case, you see, enter the items. Please pardon the spellings. I was trying to rush. So enter the items in your store. Enter nothing or enter nothing to store. So this is I could just adjust this and put an empty. So that there will be space. Just adjust this. So let's keep this one and run another. So yeah. So it asks me to enter the items in my store or enter nothing to exit. So let's see. I enter. Alright. Yeah. I have a tea. I have bread. I have coffee. I have silver. Oh, I press nothing. So it brings out the items, tea, bread, coffee, silver. And I could do a whole lot of manipulations with this. So with this, I've been able to create a list by asking the user to keep entering the items in the store. And I could do this and do multiple things without having to start creating every item. You know, this code could be written as enter the first item, we'll save it, enter the second item, enter the third item. When I start having, it will be lots. So list helps you to reduce deduplication. We use it for deduplication of our items. So that'll be that for list. In this video, we'll